This is episode 12 of Pod Jak'd. No Faps or no Fappin'. This whole episode's going to be about loads. So I know some of you guys are going to be like, ew, dude, nobody wants to hear about your loads, man. I'm not going to listen to this episode. Well, life is all about loads when you think about it. I mean, think about it. You know, a lot of people say we would have been here if it wasn't for someone shooting a load in a vagina, and then the vagina shooting out the baby. But without the cream, you can't get to the crop. Wait, what does that mean? I don't know. Well, anyways, I found out about this many years ago. I was 20. If you don't want to listen to the episode, don't listen to it. Who cares, really? I mean, only a couple hundred people listen to this out of 2,000, so it's already a failure anyway, like everything else I do. But I remember finding out about NoFaps when I was like mid-20s. Some of you have followed Simple Pickup before. And Simple Pickup were three guys. It was an Indian guy, an Asian guy, and a half Asian, half white guy. And they started making YouTube videos and them going around college campuses. They started the whole Get Her Number episode things. And I was a follower of them. I thought it really worked. I thought it was going to get me laid. And they put out a video that said no fapping and explained why it was important to not fap. And they pretty much said in the video that if you fap, that the reason why it's bad is because it doesn't motivate you, it makes you lazy. So they made this whole deal with each other. I'm not sure if they really did this or not, because it could be bullshit, but they said they made a deal with each other. Hey, listen, let's not fap for 30 days. The only way you can come is if you get laid, not by masturbating. And they started approaching more girls, and they started getting more lays because they were so horny, they were going crazy. They would just, you know, run out of their apartment and just start approaching girls. So, of course, I believed in this, too, because I was brainwashed by PUA like some of yous were. And I decided to stop doing this. The first time I did this, I made it like 2.5 weeks. And I think I just rolled over and I came on myself. Isn't that weird? I was like, what the fuck? Then I tried it again. I failed and failed. And then I made it like 3 weeks. And then I messed up. And then finally, after like 4 or 5 tries, I made it 30 days without whacking myself. And I got to tell you, no faps doesn't work. There are benefits to it. There are pros and cons, which we will get into later. But it hurts, man. It's painful. We all know what it's like. For most guys, some guys can't go a day without, you know, jerking off or coming, whatever. But if you've gone a few days before, you know, you get that blue balls feeling. Your balls just kind of fill up. And I remember my balls were just scraping against my leg one day at work. And my boss was like, what happened? I had a female boss. And I said, oh, I fell off the treadmill yesterday or something. I made up some excuse. I said, yeah, I fell off the elliptical, I hurt myself a little bit. I'm okay because I couldn't even walk. I mean, think about it. I'm a young guy in my sexual prime, and my balls are just filled with jizz. It's crazy. And I remember I told this story before. I might have turned it on this podcast or not, but I was, I think I was like 3 weeks in. I was in the salsa bar, and at first it was okay. I felt fine. And then next thing you know, my balls just started like twisting up. And I tried to dance with this black girl, and she just put her butt on my dick for like a second, and she moved away. And then I tried to dance with her again, and she wouldn't dance with me. She just teased me, and my balls were killing me. And then when I got outside, and I started walking around, all of a sudden, I was walking with a limp, like an old man. I had people laughing at me, like, what the hell? Why the hell is he walking like that? I couldn't even walk. Then when I got home, something felt painful underneath my pelvis. I had like a rash. I had a rash underneath my dick, and I went inside the shower, and I washed it with soap, and it burned, because my big balls was scraping against my pelvis. And I know, I can imagine the reactions of the guys listed. It's like, I don't want to hear about your balls and your pelvis, but damn it, I gotta tell somebody this, you know? This is information out there that could be useful to somebody, really. So that happens, and I made it pretty much the longest I made it without cranking myself was 5 months and 3 weeks. I could have went the whole year, and I regret not doing it, but the reason why I decided to get rid of it, because I already proved I can do it. But I remember I was walking around the park doing day game, and I felt like there was cum in my brain. I felt like there was something swimming around in my head, and I realized that's semen in my head from almost a year without me jizzing. And I decided to go home. I put a towel on the bed, and I decided to see if it was going to be a big load. And it was a pretty big load, but it wasn't like what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a fountain. I thought it was going to like shoot across the room, and it didn't. So I finally got rid of it. But if I can go back, I would have went a year, because I know I can do it. If I wanted to now, I could say I'm going to go a year but it's just a matter of I don't want to. So those are some stories there about the so what are the pros and cons? I would say one of the pros about nofapid is you will feel like more energy. You will feel it takes a few days or so, because I think it's something like only 3 or 4 days is the max you can hold up sperm. And then after that, I don't know what happens to the old sperm. I don't know if it goes away, but you just can't build up any more sperm, I guess. That's how it works. But one of the pros is I remember I used to feel well rested. I used to only get, you know, still to this day, only get 5 or 6 hours of sleep, especially if you have a stupid day job. And I remember just, you know, feeling fresh in the morning. I wasn't tired. You know, sometimes you fap at night, think I work the next day, and you're yawning, and you need a nap, and you feel tired. And, you know, of course, ejaculated makes you tired, as we all know. I remember my health teacher, his name was Mr. Heimendinger, and he was German, but he didn't have the German accent. He told me, he said that the reason why the balls aren't the same size is because they would scrape against each other. So that's why one ball is bigger than the other. And he also told me in the summertime, you lose sperm because, you know, it's so hot outside. When it gets too hot, the sperm starts to disappear. So that's why guys are fighting in the summer, because cum is disappearing out of their brain. Okay, so I told you this whole episode was going to be about loads. So one of the pros are you're going to feel like more energy. As far as motivation goes, I think motivation comes within. Motivation is not always about, you know, what you do sometimes. It's like, you know what I mean? Like, you could still be lazy and not, because was I approaching more girls? I wasn't really approaching more girls. I was approaching about the same. When I started doing this and I was like, you know, really fucking horny, I feel like girls can smell it on you. You know, like they have a scent. And if you're too fucking horny, it's like they can just sense that and they back away from you. It's kind of weird. And I remember I just wanted pressure against my dick. I wanted them to just, my dream was to come on the dance floor. That was an actual dream. I remember I came close before. I remember I was in this Caribbean bar and I was dancing with this black chick and I closed my eyes and I was pressing my dick really hard against her butt and I felt like I was almost there, but of course she moved away. Her friend probably pulled her away. And if I had 30 more seconds, folks, I would have made the back of her dress very sticky. But of course that didn't happen. So you feel more energy, motivation. I would say you might feel a little bit more motivated, but once again, motivation comes from within. And of course, you know, one of the biggest cons of this is you're going to feel, of course, when you get that blue balls feeling, it's going to fucking hurt. I mean, it really does. I mean, guys say, oh, I take cold showers and all that shit. That shit doesn't work. I remember I took a cold shower once when I had blue balls. And I remember cold water was just bouncing off my big balls. It actually hurt more. It didn't do anything. So some guys say it works. I don't think it works for me. It may work for you. But you're going to get that blue balls feeling, and it's very uncomfortable. Once you get through it, though, then I would say it's kind of weird. It feels like you kind of just feel less horny. You don't feel horny at all. It just goes away, which is kind of nice when you don't feel horny, because you feel like the only reason why we desire women so much is because we're so horny. But when it goes away and you don't feel horny, you're like, I don't even need, there's no point even talking to girls at this point. Must be nice to get older. To get older, like, I don't have to worry about this anymore. I don't have to worry about talking to these girls. I don't have to worry about dealing with them. It's easier to do now. It's going to be even easier when you get older because you're going to lose more and more sperm. You're not going to be as horny. Sex drive starts to go away even when you hit 30. So there's definitely pros and cons to doing this. But as far as doing this in a pickup artist way, it is not going to get you laid. If you're doing this thinking, and there's actually guys I used to read on Reddit. Actually, just before Reddit, it might have been Reddit. They said, I typed in no faps and I found some pickup website. I think it was bodybuilder.com or something. And these guys said, don't do it. I had a date with a girl and I never had this problem. And I was doing the no faps thing. We were making out and stuff in my car and I couldn't get hard. And he was pissed off because I was so fucking pissed off. It doesn't work. And it's true that masturbation makes you hornier, you know, so if you have a date coming up or something, then it probably is good to probably jerk off a day before, the, you know, night before or something. But, you know, that doesn't always happen. And pretty much, like I said, you control your sexual energy. Then if you control your sexual energy, you don't feel horny. And that's what happened to those guys. They weren't used to that. So it's not that it doesn't make you horny at all. It's just that it just, you know, once again, you're in a different headspace. That's why I said, you know, if you're going to, you know, these guys, a simple pickup are like, hey, do it. It makes you horny. Well, I mean, it makes you motivated. That's not always true. So it's not going to work. These pickup artists come up with all these things, try not to go without masturbating and stuff. And I think it's definitely worth trying. I will say, you know, you feel proud of yourself. If you're, we all start out, I'm pretty sure, as chronic masturbators, whacking it all day. And then when you can go a day without it, 2 days without it, 3 days without it, a week without it, a month without it, you do feel good, because there's only so many times you can jerk off and you just feel terrible about yourself. There's only so many times you can jerk off and you're like, is this going to be the rest of my life? Is the rest of my life going to be coming in a sock? Yeah, or coming, whatever you guys do, coming napkins or tissues or your toilet, whatever. It's like, is this going to be the rest of my life? Because this is too much. It's fine for a little while. So you definitely feel proud of yourself. And as I said before, if I could went back, I would have went a whole year. And as far as approaching girls go, like I said, I don't know what it is, but it didn't work for me at all. I wanted to come on the dance floor. That didn't work. And I didn't get laid or anything. And I remember, girls won't even go near me. It's almost like they could smell it. They could smell my load or something. It's like they could sense something. They wouldn't even, I couldn't even get a girl to even dance with me, talk to me. I don't know what it was. I was like, fuck, this sucks. This shit does not work. And once again, as far as motivation goes, some guy made a video. I'm for sure you guys saw it. It's the pros of fapping. And he said some successful men, like boxers, would go 30 days without sex. And this guy who was a genius would go 30 days without it. But, you know, once again, sometimes that shit works. Sometimes it doesn't. So reframe yourself. But it is much easier. I would say when you get older, it is easier to do it. When you're in your 20s and stuff, it's going to be hard. But when you get like 30 and your libido starts to go down, it's pretty easy. Like I went 4 days this week without even doing it, without even trying to do it. And then, of course, last night for some reason, because I stayed in, I decided to whack it, which I should have done, by the way. I should have. Now I feel like tired and I feel... So you are going to feel tired. You are going to feel, you know, once again, sometimes you get stressed out. You feel depressed when you do this too much in a row, especially, you know, the fact you want to get laid and you have to whack yourself off. But, you know, also some other pros to, of course, masturbation is you don't have to deal with women. You know how that is? Sometimes you just make yourself come and you're like, hey, fuck this. At least I have to it's amazing how sometimes you're so fucking horny. You're like, I feel like I want to call a prostitute right now. You know, like I'm so fucking horny. Like I feel like I want to go on Craigslist or something or one of those sites and get me a hooker. Then you decide to whack off and you're like, imagine if every guy did that. Imagine every guy said, I'm not going to call this girl for a date. I'm just going to jerk off. And we just left women alone. I mean, the species would die off once again. The human race, which would be some of our dreams. Some guys in MGTOW are for that. But it would never happen in a million years. But imagine if every guy did that. Every guy just like, I'm just going to jerk off. I'm not going to call this chick. I'm not going to text her. I'm just going to whack myself off and go to sleep. And leave women alone. And that would be great. But, of course, it doesn't always work that way, for guys will always send a text or call hoping that they'll get laid. But of course, as I said before, I did this off and on for years and I just gave up and it doesn't work. I actually, one of the TFL guys, one of the black guys in the You Wouldn't Like Me If When I Get Good a channel, they actually made a video about it and they said it doesn't work. I didn't watch the whole thing, but once again, it doesn't work. There's no such thing as a guarantee, just like pickup artists. You know, pickup artists tell you, oh, if you go out and you do ABC, 1, 2, 3, XYZ, that's going to work. And it doesn't. The 6-step method, the 10-step method, the 20-step method, the 80-step method, no matter what they tell you, it's not going to work. Because there's no guarantee, because we're talking about women here, these cunts. And it's up to them. They control your fate. And usually when they control your fate, it's never a good thing. As we all know, as we all learn. Well, folks, I'm all loaded out. Most of these episodes are usually over 20 minutes. I thought I had more. But there's only so much, I guess, you could talk about loads. So this is going to be a shorter episode. As far as what I talked about in the last episode about the Asian guy, the tall mixed Chang guy, I don't think he's going to be on the show. Oh, yeah, so one thing about him before we wrap this up. I already know the guy's phony because he's obviously saying looks don't matter and stuff. But he was making fun of my jacket last week. He got mad because whenever I go to his bar, it's not his bar, he's just a bouncer there, he always goes, man, there's tons of women in there. Usually there's like 5 girls in there. I'm like, dude, you keep saying there's tons of girls. There's like 5 girls in there. And he's like, well, all you need is one. And I go, well, that's true, but you keep saying that. So I was making fun of it last week. I was like, dude, there was so many girls in there. And then he got mad. He was like, I don't like that jacket. But here's why he's a phony. About 6 months ago, he actually told me he liked my jacket. He was like, hey, I like your jacket. It's like last year. And now he said last week, oh, I don't like that jacket. So now he doesn't like it. So it just goes to show he talks so much shit. But I'm not going to be able to get him on the show probably anyway because it's just, it's really cold out. It's going to be like 20-something degrees tonight. The cold ball weather has officially hit the East Coast. And I'm not going to be able to stand outside. I mean, even if it's only 20 minutes, I don't think he's busy working, checking IDs. So I would have to, you know, talk to him after like 2:30 in the morning. So he's not going to be a guest on the show, even though I would like him to be a guest on the show. You know, some of you wouldn't like him because I know he's going to say looks don't matter and you guys need to just say hi and all that good looking guy shit. But anyways, yeah, let's end this one and we'll put another one right after this one. Dating coaches. So let's get to this. Let's talk about, the topic was supposed to be dating coaches. So I'll just add this in right now. I actually forgot someone gave a good suggestion on the last episode, especially female dating coaches. So let's add this right in. I'm sorry. I'm all over the place now, but once again, who cares? Just listen, man. Just listen and learn. As far as dating coaches go, I would never pay. I actually met two guys from RSD before, briefly. I met Julian Blanc, as you all know. And I met Todd, and I met somebody else. I didn't meet Tyler, but I think, was it Max? I forgot who it was. It might have been just Todd twice. But one night I was in Center City, and Todd had a student. And I said, hey, Todd, I know you're busy right now. I just want to say hi. And he said, oh, thanks, man. And they all look weird. They all look like they're on drugs or they're, you know, they probably are. They're probably on coke or something for all the money they make. And actually, I saw Jeffy one night. He was coaching these two guys. He was barely helping them. He was playing with his cell phone while this white and this black kid was going around approaching girls, and he was barely watching them and barely helping them. This is what they do. But as far as let's talk about female dating coaches first. We all know one of them, they have RSD Sarah now, which is a joke. What can she teach you? Like, first of all, it's bad enough that these guys scam you. We all know that taking advice from a woman, even though guys scam you and guys don't know what they're talking about, fucking females will tell you, just be nice, you know, just be nice, just be her friend, just make her feel comfortable, don't just, like, that's what a girl told me, and I listen. A girl told me, just be nice, just, you know, make a girl, just be a girl's friend first, and girls didn't even want to be my friend. Remember, it's all about value. A girl's only going to be your friend if they want something from you. So she puts you in a category. What can this guy do for me? Can he fix my computer? No, I already have a guy for that. Can he pick me up at the airport 2 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday night? No, I already have a guy for that. Can he take me out? Blah, blah, blah. They put you in some sort of category. And if they don't have a category for you, then they're just not going to be your friend. They won't even be your friend and use you if they already have enough guys. So what can they teach you? What can they possibly teach you that's going to get you laid? The chick's name is Keja Mobile. Or Keja or something. You guys have heard of her. She's like this foreign chick. And she's with that foreign guy from Seduction, whatever. And some of you guys have probably seen her video. She has little titties hanging out and everything. And it's like, listen, what can she possibly teach you? I actually read her book. I actually illegally downloaded her book years ago. And she just posted some, like, it was just a weird book. It was like, I told a guy to do this. I told a guy to go up and buy a girl a drink, and he did. But it's like, what can they possibly... You can't relate to them. You can't relate to a girl telling you, hey, go over to that girl and buy her a drink and stuff. Of course she's going to say buy her a drink because that's all women really want. And so as far as RSD goes, many years ago, they had a free tour, but it was a small one. They had one in a hotel. And this guy, one of the only PUA guys I still talk to, his name is Marco. Some of you know I talk about him on my main channel. He's pretty cool. He's like, even though he's a PUA guy and he's brainwashed, he's kind of cool. He's got a good sense of humor and he's pretty cool. He's not a dickhead like some of the other guys. He invited me. It was in a DoubleTree hotel. I didn't go, but then afterwards, the next night, they were just trying to recruit guys for their boot camp. And it was Julian, it was Todd, and I think that was it. It was just those two guys. And it was in the room of this bar. And I walked in late, and Julian was very nice. He smiled at me. He said, hey, what's up, man? I shook his hand. The other guy shook my hand. I think it was Todd or somebody else. And then I missed, like, most of it. And they were like, the guys were asking questions, and they were rolling their eyes at them. You can tell they had no interest in helping these guys. They had no interest in really talking to these guys. And then finally, Julian was just like, okay, who's coming to the hot seat tomorrow? Because, you know, that's where they make their money. They show their fake infield footage. And then so guys raise their hand and say, okay, good, guys. I'll see you guys at the hot seat. And they walked out. And actually, Tyler, I just missed him, I think, the day before. I was talking to someone. I said, yo, Tyler just walked up the block up there. He doesn't like when people talk to him when he's eating a dinner. Like some guy approached him while he was eating a steak, and he got really mad. He doesn't like that or something, which is like, okay. I mean, someone pays you $5,000. You figure, hey, I can approach you for while you're eating your steak, right? I guess not. So, and I saw Todd, as I said, one night before, and Jeffy. So I've actually seen a few RSD guys out in Philly randomly. But dating coaches can't help you. As I said before, there's nothing they can do. They can tell you, okay, go out 7 days a week and approach five girls a day. That's still not going to help you. That's still not going to help you. I did it. I was going out almost 7 days a week, approaching at least five girls a day, and I got nothing. So what are you going to tell me? Once again, oh, you weren't confident enough. You weren't fucking good enough. You didn't go out. You didn't go hard enough or something. You didn't pop a Viagra. What do you mean by that? You know, like, what else am I supposed to do? And now we have RSD Sarah. Let's type in RSD Sarah and see what comes up. I'm not sure if she actually started putting up content. It actually says infield. Is she a lesbian? It says three weird steps to make any group love you. Now, once again, a woman is going to teach you how to love you. Isn't it different for a woman to get people to love you? I mean, think about that. A woman can just stand there and just smile and be a beautiful woman and everyone's going to love her. If you're a guy, unless you look like a bottle, if you just stand there and smile, everyone's gonna look at you like you're retarded. Three ways to start an epic conversation. Yeah, if anybody knows how to start a conversation, it's a woman, right? She talks about her stupid jobs, talks about her stupid date or something. What else does she have? She doesn't have that many videos. Hey, is anybody else surprised? She doesn't have a lot of content. She only has 12 videos and she's been out for a year. Because you have nothing to say. It says, are you the life or a party or a nerd? The power mindset, you against failure. Once again, this is all just, you know, this is no different in marketing. You got to market yourself. You know, I used to believe I was $1 million, folks. I'm the most defeated guy ever. I used to say, you know, you're the baddest motherfucker on this block. Nobody can fuck with you. All these bitches want your dick. And now I'm the most defeated guy ever. Doesn't work. What else? Become the leader that everyone admires. Break through false beliefs and become a leader. Even her titles suck. How to connect with people in an emotionally unemotionally expressive places. So once again, so a woman once again can easily make friends because girls can bond on girly stuff, and girls can bond on just emotional stuff, and then guys of course want to be girls' friends because they want to fuck them. So it's way easier for girls to make friends than guys. Way harder for guys to make friends because it's all about value, and even guys don't want to hang out with you if you have nothing to offer. And as we said before, girls aren't going to want to hang out with you. But a guy hit me up on the I was on the attraction forums years ago, and this guy hit me up, and I posted an ad looking for a wingman. And the attraction forums, that's Magic Bullets. Have you guys ever heard of that? It's like some of the guys used to know mystery. They decided to start their own thing and make it less complicated. One guy hit me up and said, hey, man, I've seen you've been posting ads and stuff looking for a wingman. How long have you been doing game for? So I thought you wanted the wing. I said, yeah, I've been doing, at that point, I was like, I've been doing game for like, I don't know, 5 or 6 years, or maybe, you know. And he said, well, I offer a boot camp. I'm not sure if you heard of me. And actually, the guy Marco used to go to this douchebag bar called Ladder 15, and it was like the douchiest bar ever. I mean, the most stuck-up white girls you can possibly meet, and it's like mostly frat douchebags, just so fucking scum. You can go in there, someone could just spill a drink on you on purpose, or, you know, people just goof on you. It's just a terrible place to go. And he was like, he used to show me some of the dating coaches there, like, this guy's from Magic Bullets, this guy. So some of the dating coaches actually, still to this day, if you're ever in Philly, and you on a Saturday night, and you want to see some cringe PUA shit, go to Ladder 15 in Center City on a Saturday night and pay $5 and you'll see it. It's just guys get kicked out of the bar. It's the type of place where bouncers will kick you out if they see you approaching girls. They don't want pickup artists there because I guess some of the girls have complained that they don't know the guys are pickup artists, but that they're being approached and stuff. So guys will kick you out for having too much fun. But he hit me up and he said, dude, I can teach you, blah, blah, blah. And I said, how can you teach me? I've been making hundreds and hundreds of approaches. I approach more girls than any guy I know. And once again, he said, oh, you must be doing it the wrong way. I could teach you the right way. I said, I listen, I don't, I live at home with my parents. Even back then, I was like, I don't have any money. And I'm, you know, okay, well, let me know. I think he hit me up again. I just ignored him. And then finally, I ended with this. There was a local guy. This guy wasn't even, like, he tried to act like RSD. He was just a guy. This is how gullible guys are. This is sad. I think I talked about this on the show before in my first couple of episodes, but I bring it up again since it pertains to this. He called me even. And I met this guy a few times, and he said, hey, man, he started a YouTube channel just like RSD, stealing their content, like copying them, like saying what they would say. And he called me up, and he was like, hey, man, he's like, I seen you out before. You seem okay. You seem pretty good, but I can teach you the right way. All this stuff is, I get late every single weekend. I asked about you before. They said you really don't get results. I can help you. And at the time, I just moved back into my parents' house. And I had no money. I was like, dude, I know you don't believe me. I have no money. I was like, I just lost my apartment. I'm financing a car right now. I only have a little bit of money. I built it up just to pay my car and stuff. I was like, I have nothing, okay? So he was making fun of me one night. He was like goofing on me because I didn't want to take his stupid boot camp. He was like, oh, yeah, I asked somebody about you. And they said you only got laid like one time. I said, no, I didn't get laid one time in my life. I said I got laid one time doing pickup, whatever, which is actually more than what most guys have done. And he was just a dick. And I actually ran into him in the summer. And he kept telling me my breath stunk. He got mad. He was like passive aggressive because I told him PUA doesn't work. And I guess he got mad. So he said, hey, dude, can you put a piece of gum in your mouth? I said, first of all, I brushed my teeth and I gargled before I left the house. And I was just chewing a piece of gum before we talked. So my breath doesn't stink. He said, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be rude. He was like, but your breath stinks. I said, okay. And then he came over to me again 5 minutes later and said, yo, dude, you still didn't put a piece of gum in your mouth? I said, can you just leave me alone? I don't want to hang out with you. He was like, no, I'm sorry, man. I'm just trying to help you. So he's just a passive aggressive dude, but he said he used to teach guys boot camps. He actually scammed a guy out of $3,000. Many guys, it was a short Asian guy. And what happened was I met this short Asian dude. It was either off Craigslist or one of those sites, you know, or attraction forums or pickup, simple pickup or something. And he was like, I'm thinking about taking a boot camp because I wanna get better. You know, I said, it's not gonna make you better. What can they teach you? It's up to you. And he said, I don't have time. I just want to pay it over. So he told me about the dude, and he said, I want to take his boot camp. I said, he's a scam artist. I said, he's just calling random guys off the internet. I said, you don't even know this guy. You're going to give him $3,000? He said, he seems legit. So long story short, I ran into him months later. I was walking out of a bar. He was walking in. He said, hey, man, I should have listened to you. I never should have gave that guy $3,000. You're right. It's all about you. It's all about what you do. And I said, yeah, I try to help you. And then that was it. So, once again, it's so sad that guys are willing to give $3,000. Like, I can understand why someone would pay RSD even though they're scammed because, you know, they have a big following and they're like, these guys worship them and they're like rock stars and stuff, you know. I can kind of understand even though they're scam artists, but to give it to a random guy who just called, like, I can do that right now if I wanted to. I can just call random dudes who post their number and go, dude, and if I call 100 guys, I could probably get 3 or 5 guys, if not 10. Sign up for my boot camp, but I wouldn't do that because I'm not a piece of shit. And plus, I'm paranoid somebody might kill me. So anyways, so I merged this into two topics. I totally forgot about the dating coach thing. It just popped into my head. So this episode will be no fapping and dating coaches, which is fine. It's okay to merge different topics. And that's it. So I did a lot of rambling. I'm not trying to make these too long because I don't know who the hell wants to listen to me ramble for that long. But thank you for listening. I look forward to your feedback. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Pod Jak'd.